But still, my father told me to do medicine. So that's why I landed in Manipal. I finished MBBS, and the first day of my medical school, I decided that I should be a heart surgeon. So I was focused and I wanted to do only heart surgery, nothing else. And when I finished medicine and I joined general surgery, first day of my general surgery, I decided that I should be a heart transplant surgeon. So it was like 15-20 years ago that I decided that I should be a transplant surgeon. And when I finished my general surgery, I was just like going around the country like to do cardiac surgery. And I was coming to Swami's Hospital, Whitefield, from 2003 as a part of general surgery work. But I was never attracted or pulled towards Swami's Hospital or Swami's mission. So I was just going around the country to do the best place where to do the cardiac training. And my wife, she was an intern under me in general surgery. So she told me that if you want to cardiac surgery, you should visit Whitefield once. Then you can take a decision. So that was the first time I entered the cardiac department in Whitefield. Till then I was never entered cardiac department in Whitefield. I didn't even know like how the cardiac department in Whitefield. So the first time I entered and I was amazed the amount of work they do in cardiac. So I decided, yes, this is the place I should do cardiac training. And it's not that easy to get into Swami's Hospital for training. It's a tedious process. So I wrote entrance exam, they have an interview, they have an interview with the surgeons, and they have an interview with the trust people. So it's not that easy. But again, it's all Swami who decides. I came first in the entrance interviews, I got selected. So I was just telling Pradosh. So I got selected, I got the letter that you are selected for the cardiac training in Sathya Hospital. So next day I went and told like, look, I got the letter, so when should I join? Then they told like, you cannot join. And then like, I told like, no, I came first in the entrance, first in the interview, like why can't I join? Then they told, no, like this is the result of your entrance exam. This is not, that doesn't mean that you are selected. The Swami decides whether you can join or not. And I was taken back. What is this? I'm buried. I'm qualified. This is what it is. And Swami will decide. So then, by the time I already missed all the MCHCs in the country. I got in Vellore, Trivandrum. I told like, no, I'm going to Sathya. So everything is over, the year is gone. So if I don't get into Sathya, then I have to waste 1 year. I was like, I was a bit depressed. Then within 4 days, like they called me and told me that Swami has approved your this thing, you can join. So I was the happiest person. You know, like when you get an MBBS medical seat, like how happy you'd be. You would be in cloud nine. So I was like, wow, I got cardiac training in Sathya Hospital, happiest person. So I joined and just like, I was like amazed at the concept of Swami's mission and this thing, but I was not like still pulled towards Swami. And I used to work day in and day out, and that time Swami used to come to Vrindavan. So when Swami comes to Vrindavan, the entire hospital is standstill because everybody is in Vrindavan. Nobody will be in the hospital to work. So I was like, okay, fine, I get more opportunity to do surgery. So I used to take my colleagues' cases also, I used to do surgery. So I was like operating day and night, I was very happy. Because like, as a surgeon, like the hands-on operating surgical technique is most important. So I got so many materials, like I got so many patients to operate, so I was happy. But retrospectively, when I think that I missed so many chances, like those days Swami will come and talk to the doctors, talk to the surgeon, he will ask what surgery did you do today, how was it, any new technique. But retrospectively, when I think, I missed all those chances because I was just like working. And the year went on and I came for the exam, like December was my exam, and Swami sent a message saying that December, like I want to see all the doctors of Whitefield. And I told like, for the same day where I have to give the exam. It was December 9th and 10th, those 2 days, Saturday and Friday, Saturday. And the same day Swami has given the invitation for all the doctors in Whitefield, like I want to see all the doctors and families. So it was like very rare opportunity for the doctors and family to come. So So I thought like, no, I can't come, I have my exams. So I told my wife and my newborn son, okay, you can go, you can take my in-laws, because my wife, my in-laws, they're all devotees for say about 60, 70 years. The grandparents, parents and my wife, they're all devotees, but still I was not pulled. So I remember like, okay, fine, you can take my in-laws and son, you can go and have darshan with Swami. I mean, exams, I can't come. Then like just the day before my exam and the Puttaparthi trip, Swami told, I don't want to see them this week, ask them to come next week. So I was like, okay, fine, like I will be free of my exams, I can come. So then the next weekend, just the day before, like my colleagues came and told me, no, Kumaran, you took leave 2 weeks for exam, so you can't go this weekend, because we want to go, we have to work this weekend. Then I thought, okay, fine, the same thing. My wife, my kids, and my in-laws can go. I will stay there because like my colleagues didn't give me permission. Then that time, like my chief authority, Dr. Vati Chaudhary, he asked me, why are you not coming? I thought, like, also, like, my colleague, I have taken exams, leave. So my colleague, he wanted me to work this weekend. Then he told, no, it's okay, I will sort that matter. You come to the trip. I want you to come. Because, like, my chief, he knows that I'm a workaholic and I was not into Swami's mission. And, like, he knows that the moment I finish my exams, I get my degree, like, I'll be out of the hospital. So he wants me to experience, like, the Swami and Puttaparthi and everything. So, you know, that was my first trip to Puttaparthi in 3 years. First trip of mine and my newborn son. So I thought, like, okay, fine, we all go. So we went to Puttaparthi and we had a first 1 day we went all along. Sunday, Swami sent a message saying that I want to meet the doctor's family and doctors in the cycle work hall. So we all went and sat. So as usual, like there'll be the doctors usually get the first row preference. But in Kumaran's hall, our doctors. So who's in the first row? I thought like my colleagues are all like running inside to catch the first 2-3 rows. I thought, please go. So I went and sat at the last row. And my wife and kid, they were sitting in the front row. And my son, he was 9 months. So he was crawling and you still can know the large lamps in the Kumaran hall. So I was catching the lamp, he was trying to shake it and everything. So the samadhal came and told like, this guy is making too much of noise. Either take him to the last row or send him home. So my mother-in-law, she told like, no, I'll take the Aryan and she went back. And back also was making too much of noise. Like then they came and told, this guy is making too much of noise, you take him outside. So my mother-in-law, she took my son outside and she was walking outside. And there outside several people like, no, this is a rare opportunity for you because Swami doesn't call the families, they usually call doctors. So families are a rare opportunity, you should not miss. So she told, you give the son to me, you go inside. So when she came inside, Swami came, they closed the doors. So son is outside, me, my wife and my mother was inside. So Swami came and Swami just went around all the doctors and everything. And Swami came and sat, and Swami, after 5 minutes, Swami called my wife. Like, come here. So my wife went and like, Swami and everything. Your son is crying outside, bring him inside. And then like, my wife was like, no, no, he's sitting in the last row. And then she saw my mother-in-law, like, no son, he's outside. And like, everybody was shocked, like, to whom did you give my son? She doesn't know. So they went outside and they searched for 5-10 minutes and my wife told like my mother-in-law like you'll keep searching, I'll go inside. So she came inside and after 5 minutes again Swami called my wife and told, the son is still crying, so call him inside. Then that time like all the sevadas they joined. Okay fine, this looks like it's a serious issue. You should find your son. And like when everything was going on, like I was getting a little worried. Like, why my wife and my mother-in-law going around? Then I asked like somebody what happened. No, I think they have lost their son. I told them, it's my son. So I also came outside and like I couldn't find my son. Because like my mother-in-law also like she forgot like who's the sevadar? And which sevadar took my son? Nobody knows. So I was getting panicked. Then I went around half an hour and everything, I couldn't find. Then on 7th, I came and told him, no, your son is back in the colon hall, you please come. So then I was like, okay, fine, peace of mind. I went inside and my wife was like kicking my son in the first row. And then he was trying to move around. And Swami told like, no, no, leave him alone. Like, he'll be fine, he won't do anything. So my wife, she left and she went straight to the lamp and he was pulling the lamp. And then like Swami was looking at him and laughing. Then Swami called him, like, what's his name? Actually, like, everybody told not to tell the name because Swami will keep the name. And she told, like, his name is Ali, nice name. And Swami was talking to him, and like, finally, like, everybody telling me, like, I was sitting in the last row, oh, this is a nice opportunity, go friend will talk to Swami. I told, like, no, the protocol is like Swami will call. You cannot just jump and go and talk. I told, you know, I wait, Swami will call. Then, like, Swami asked, like, where's the father? And, like, they told, like, then Swami called me. I went and I was like, wow, it's like 1,000 volt bulb, like, standing there and, like, full of light. I was like, even doing, when I gave my exams also, I was not so tense. So, like, hands were shivering and was looking at Swami. Swami asked, what is your name? I told only my half name. Then, like, Swami asked, you look so tense, what happened? I told, like, how can I tell, like, Swami, I'm in front of you, I will be tense. And I told Swami, you know, Swami, I gave my exams, I'm ready to go to the results. And, like, Swami really smiled and told, well, you didn't study properly. So, like, Swami, I studied, but the exam results are, like, but they are very strict. And being a family man, having children, and especially to in-laws, you cannot tell, I failed my exam, I have to give once more. So I was like, I wrote my exam with Swami, but I'm a little tense. So like Swami told, like, you have a very bad habit. I told, like, what is the bad habit I have now? I told, like, no, you give up very easily. You don't pursue, you don't, like, go till the end and fight for it. I told, like, yes, Swami, I have that. Then Swami told, like, don't worry, everything will be fine. Then Swami gave a Padamaskaram and told, like, what I told you, keep in mind, don't give up fast. Go till the end, try for it, and at the end you will succeed. Like, okay, thank you, Swami. Then I came and everybody were like, Swami has told you will pass. Swami has told you will pass. And I told, like, then I told everybody. That time, like, all over the country, 45 students give exam. And the result is less than 10%. Only 3 or 4 will pass. And when I gave my exams, like, they already told only two people have passed. And one is a girl. And, like, a lot of brilliant and intelligent students are there, so I won't be that one. So I thought, like, Swami has told you will pass. I thought, like, say, in 45, there are only 3 or 4 girls, so one girl has passed. So in 41, only one. So I'm sure it's not me. It'll be somebody else. So, but Swami is based on the results came, only 2 people have passed and I was the one. So, when all these things happened, that was the time I understood, yes, Swami is divine. Till that time, like, I was never good. And Swami knows, like, when to pull the string. Swami decides, like, when to call and whom to call. So I think the calling came at the right time. So that time I decided, yes, he is divine, he is not like any other spiritual guru, he is avatar. So and that time my chief was very much sure that I am not going to leave the hospital. Because he knew that I am, like, totally a transformed person. So I finished my exams, got the degree, and immediately the next day my chief gave me the job. From today onwards you are staff, this is your operation theater, you can do the surgeries. So in India, especially in India, like once you get the MCH, you can't be independent surgeon. It takes a lot of time, at least say about 7-8 years till you become independent cardiac surgeon, because like there is quite so much of training. But in Swami's institute, I have already done so much in 3 years during the training period. So that day when they came, I started operating independently. Whenever I used to get a complex case, I used to call chief, he will come and help. But in 3 months, 4 months, I was doing all the complex cases. And it's common that because the cardiac surgeons and neurosurgeons, they always think they are next to the God. Because that's the amount of knowledge and training, and they started thinking. So at that, immediately after I finished, and when I got this job, when I was doing cases like hundreds, 200s, automatically my ego goes up. And I started doing surgeries where like my seniors, they were refused. This is complex, this is sick, you cannot do cardiac surgery, this is the end of it. Just take medicines, 2-3 years, that's it maximum. But like, I don't know, I feel that like, no, I can do. So I started doing all the complex cases. And 2 years, 3 years, I was like, so much grace, no mortalities, by doing such complex sick cases. So I thought like, my ego has gone there. So I was thinking that yes, in my hands, like, nothing will happen. So it has gone beyond the limit. So, but Swami gave a beautiful check. So I was doing cases, and one day they just sent me a simple case, very simple, straightforward case. The mortality will be like, in experience, and less than 1%. But I lost the child. I was like, it was like happened. I did a complex case in the morning. Patient just like flew off the operation theater, ICU. And like simple case, and I took the case, I lost the child. It was like first mortality in my career. I was like devastated. Like especially when you're not trained to take the failure, the first failure hits you very hard. So I was like devastated. The reason is like, I don't know what happened, because everything was perfect. When everything is perfect, the result has to be perfect. The result can't be failure. So I was like taken aback. So I stopped operating for 3 days, 4 days, and then my chief called, like, we are not operating. I go like, sir, I have to find out what happened to the child. And my chief told like, you did your best. You can't give success for all the patients. But I told like, when everything is perfect, the result has to be perfect. It's like 1 + 1 = 2. It can't be -0. So like, this is not mathematics, this is cardiac surgery, you are dealing with life. So someone else decides whether he has to live or die. It's not you. I told like, no, it's not like that. When you join both things, it has to be joined. This is simple. You close the hole, yes. It has to be like, heart has to function, why the heart didn't function. So I didn't operate for 1 week, and I was like depressed, not having food properly. And in Swami's like hospital, like the center, the dome area is there. So on Thursday evening night around 7 o'clock, and nobody was there. So I went, I sat, and I was just like talking to Swami, like, why this happened? Like, I know you are divine, you can give me an answer. Like, why this happened? And like, I just got a WhatsApp message. Somebody has forwarded exactly at that time. Because like Swami's disclosure. It always, in the disclosure, Swami is still like, you are just an instrument in my hand. I decide what will do. The patient has to live or die, I will decide, not you. If it is a success, it is not yours. I have decided the patient has to live, so you are just a medium. You are just like, I am giving you, you are giving to the patient. You are just an instrument. And something goes wrong, it is for me. Something goes good, success is for me, failure is for me. You don't have to do anything in that. So that was one message I got strongly. From that time onwards, like any patient I touch, I tell like, I'm doing my best, I'm an instrument in your hand, you tell me what is the end product. So when success doesn't go to your head, even failure doesn't go to your head. So that was the second message, big message I got from Swami. And Swami's grace till now, like, I have not got into that kind of a phase, and hopefully I will not go in the future also. So when this all went on, and like my passions, it was still ticking behind my mind, like transplant. So I prayed to Swami a lot of times, like, that is my passion, like, where I'm heading, like, just doing routine cardiac surgeries. So the transplant happens only in 3-4 places in the world. One is US, America, Canada, England, and a few places in Australia. England, I didn't want to go for some reason, but US is the main place. So if you want to learn transplant, you have to go to US. And as usual, if you want to go to US, again, you have to write exams. You have to write, like, tens and tens of exams, score, did everything, scored, got a certificate that I can do, come to US and do transplant. But still, it was like, I get a letter from the institute that I can come and do transplant, but when you go near, the door is closed. Multiple universities, they call me, universities, they just see your rank, see your CV, that's all. And they're happy, they'll give you, okay, fine, you can come and join. But the government has to decide whether you can come to US or not. So you go, the door will be closed. It happened 3-4 times. And there was a time I met Pradosh in US, where I was doing an observership in Texas. And that door was completely closed to US. So nowhere I can enter US. So the next best place to do is Canada. Canada, the only place they give excellent training is Toronto General Hospital. So the chief of Toronto General Hospital was visiting India. So I have sent numerous mails, no reply. So when he was visiting India, I told my chief here. So like the chief of Toronto General has come, I want to visit him, I want to ask him why he has not responded to my mail. I'm like, okay, fine, you can go to Lucknow. He was coming for a conference in Lucknow. And 2 days before the conference, my chief called, Kumaran, I'm going for the conference, you have to stay there. I told, like, sir, but I already booked my tickets. No, like, I have to go because I'm giving a talk. So some senior has to be stay back in Whitefield. Fine, okay. So I lost the opportunity. I thought, like, okay, fine, even Canada is closed. Then after the conference, through my colleague, I came to know that he's coming to Bangalore. I told, like, I can't miss this. Then, like, I told my chief, like, I want one day because he's coming to Bangalore, so I have to meet him. And I told, like, okay, fine, you take. So that day morning, 7 o'clock, my chief got up and told, like, you can't take you, Kumaran, because, like, I have to talk to you. I'm like, okay, I'll come and talk to you in the evening. I need to go up to my room. And I told, like, okay, fine, I think the Toronto is permanently closed. So when I went to the room to talk to him, then I got a big surprise. The Toronto chief was sitting there. So, like, then, like, he asked me, like, he introduced, he's the chief of Toronto General Hospital. Then, like, the tears came. Because, like, whose action it can be? Swami. I was roaming all over to US to do a transplant and trying to meet the chief of Toronto. But Swami brought him to my hospital, our hospital. And that day, my chief specifically, he put a complex case for me. Where even the Toronto chief, he will think twice to operate on that case. And he told in front of the chief, he's doing the case, if you're interested, you can watch him do the surgery. Then, like, I went and saw the case, and I went and told the chief, sir, if you're posting this case, you should have told me at least the day before, or prepared. But you're just giving me, like, patients already induced, he's on operating table, and you're just giving me 5 minutes notice. No, you can do it. Go and do it. And let the chief of Toronto General watch you. Like, okay. I'm instrument in Swami's hand. Let's see. And went and did the surgery. 5 hours, the chief just stood there. He didn't even move from the place. He watched me do the entire surgery. Came out beautifully. And he... In fact, he went to the ICU to see what all the patient is doing. Patient was being perfectly fine, extubated, everything. Then the chief came to me and told me, Kumaran, I have seen your mails. I'm happy. You can come and join me next year. That's how I landed in Toronto. And it didn't stop there. when you pray so hard to Swami and Swami is not giving you the answer, it's not that Swami doesn't like you or Swami doesn't want you or Swami wants to be served only in Manipal Hospital. It's not that. When Swami gives, Swami knows what is best for you. And he felt that Toronto General is the best for me. The reason is, when I went to Toronto General with the fellowship, my chief, he saw my wife's entire CV. He told that your wife is so well qualified. Is she not interested in any other fellowship? I told, sir, she's interested. She got a fellowship in the same hospital. So, that's all my wife landed in Toronto. So, this is all like, it happens in like Swami's miracles. When Swami knows what is best for you, all you have to do is have faith in Swami, wait patiently, he will answer. And you can't ask more than that. Any questions? One more thing like that. This article I wrote in Samarkand. In my 5 years, 7 years, just before I left Toronto, when I had this strong faith that whatever happens, it happens because of Swami. All you have to do is like put everything in Swami and complete faith in Swami, and he will make sure that it happens. And if it doesn't happen, it is best for you that it didn't happen. So, just 3 months, like when I gave my resignation, like I was just like taking myself little light and training my juniors. I got a call from the chief of cardiology. Like one patient had an acute MI, surgery needs to be done. And in acute heart attack, nobody will do surgery. Because like it is basically the cardiologists, they do their part. They do the stenting, or they do open up the vessel or something. The surgeon's role in acute heart attack is very, very less. And even if the surgeon takes, the mortality is almost close to 90%. Nothing much can be done. So, when I told like, I asked the chief, why can't you do anything? I told like, my side, I cannot do anything for him. It's up to the surgeons, you take a call. So I thought, okay, fine. When I went to the, when I saw the patient, my, his bad luck or my fate or anything, he had a massive arrest. So they are giving cardiac compressions and everything. And I told like, see, he's already had a heart attack and he is arrested. So nothing much can be done. So I went back to my regular, to stop my regular operation. They were giving cardiac massage for close to 40-45 minutes. And 45 minutes of cardiac massage, even the heart recovers, the brain is gone. Because there is no enough blood supply to the brain. So the brain is already gone. So you can't do, even if you do anything, it's just a futile. So then the cardiologist, they came and told, like, the heart has recovered, is with them, you come and operate. I told, like, it's 40 minutes of cardiac massage. So the brain is already gone. So nothing much you can do. And they're like, no, you should come and see the patient. So I went and saw the patient, like borderline pressures and everything. So I came back and I spoke to his wife. I told like, he had a heart attack and he had arrest. And they gave him massage for 40 minutes. So the surgery is the only option. But mortality is 90%. Even if he comes out of the surgery, his brain is almost 95%. I cannot give guarantee. I told like, we came here for Swami. And if Swami wants him to take him back with him, let him, but you do your part. I know, like, I never had that kind of leap of faith. I know, like, when she's having so much of faith in Swami, why can't I have at least 50% of that faith? I go like, okay, fine, I'll take it. And my colleagues, my resident, he go like, sir, like, you can bring back the heart function, sir, but what about the brain? Let's try, let's give it a try. So, did the surgery for 6 hours. Finished the surgery, the heart was beautiful. Heart was like pumping like a horse. It was pumping. But like, this part I'm happy, but let's see what happens to the brain. So we shifted him to the ICU. By 9 o'clock, 4 hours after the surgery, was completely awake. Awake, moving all the limbs. Next day he was out of ventilator. In 4 days he went home with just like any normal patient. have faith in Swami, you should have that kind of leap of faith. Then yes, Swami will answer all your prayers. I'll tell you a small secret. Whenever you have any problems, you have conversation with Swami. Just like sit in a silent room and talk to Swami. Like, Swami, this is what it is, and what should I do? But these conversations, you should have a tremendous faith. You can't just have a conversation like a casual. You have to have a lot of faith. Swami will answer your call. For example, like, okay, fine. I want to go abroad. I want to do this. I want to do that. When you have so much of faith and you have a conversation with Swami, this is what I do, but you can take your own chances. I always get a ringing tone. Either somebody is ringing a bell somewhere, or even like your mobile comes with a ringing tone or a message tone. So that time I'll tell, yes, Swami has given me the sign to go there. So that's how I do it. But have faith, talk to Swami, and Swami will answer. If Swami doesn't answer, Swami doesn't give you something that is for your own good. If I would have gone to US, my family would have been in India without going near the fellowships. But now, like when I went to Toronto, my wife also got to do the fellowship. She is now like, you know, the top 20 in Canada where they are trained completely in such a specific field. But there is a drawback, now she doesn't want to come back. But when Swami does, it's the best for you. So all you need to have is like faith, faith and faith. Wait patiently, Swami will answer your call. And there are a lot of things like Swami is not in physical form, like what's happening and everything. Swami is always there. Swami lives inside each one of the heart. Only thing is you have to understand that yes, Swami is inside me, Swami is in everybody's heart. Only thing is you should have faith. Yes, Swami is there. Swami will answer my calls. And He will answer everybody, every devotee's call. They shall have.